Hi everybody, here we are in the indoor overwintering room at the Honeybee Research Center, and I want to explain a little bit about how we winter some of our colonies indoors. What we move indoors are smaller colonies, and sometimes we'll move colonies in that are a little bit weaker that we don't think would make it through outdoors. So I'll describe the process and then we'll talk a bit about the kinds of colonies that we've got in here. We keep this room at 5 degrees Celsius all winter long, or as close to that as our equipment will allow, and the bees are in total darkness for that time period. If there were light in here at 5 degrees, the bees would be crawling all over the place, but in the dark they stay in their homes. We use outside air to cool the room down to 5. Each one of these beehives produces 15 watts of heat. So when you have, say, 100 hives in a room like this, that's the equivalent of running a 1500 watt electric heater. So they do generate quite a bit of heat, and we use the external air to cool the room down to 5 degrees. We've got over here all the equipment that controls the devices. We have a heating thermostat, we have a cooling thermostat, we have a time clock for the fan, and then we have a temperature alarm that would warn us if it's getting too warm or too cold in here. But being too warm is what we would be most concerned with. If it gets too warm inside an indoor wintering room, the bees start generating more heat and it can spiral out of control. The room can heat up beyond the temperature the bees can tolerate and all the hives would die. So it's very important that we are able to keep that room cool. So we set the temperature so that it stays at 5 degrees. The outside air is brought in through a duct at the far end of the room here, up in the corner there. So that duct is connected to a 10-inch squirrel cage fan, and that's sort of the heart of the system here. That will move about 2,000 cubic feet per minute of air into the room. So it's really important to have large volume, the capacity to move large volumes of air into the room to keep the room cool. So it works kind of two ways. We also need to provide ventilation. So if there was no need to adjust the temperature in the room, the same air would stay in the room and it would become stale. So we have this time clock set up over here to control the fan, and that is set so that once every hour all the air in the room is purged and we have fresh air in the room. When it's doing that, it pushes the air around in the room, and that's the time clock that you can see there. So it not only pushes air out, but it circulates the air within the room. CO2 and moisture build up in the room, so we need to be able to expel that. When that fan pressurizes the room, the only way for the air to get out of the room is off the floor, through this duct down on the floor here. There are 4 of these ducts in the room. Air goes in at the bottom, gets forced up and out through the wall, and these are all light proof. There's 2 elbows in there and the inside of the pipes are painted black, so no light can get in through that duct work there. So that's basically the mechanics of the room, with the ventilation and the control of the heat. Let's talk a little bit about what happens with the beehives when we move them in. These are full-size colonies, full-size single brood chamber colonies. Over here we have 4-way nucleus colonies. So there are 4 little colonies in there. That I think is probably too small for wintering here. We're just experimenting with that. But some of these we have divided into 2. We're working with Les Eccles with the Ontario Beekeepers Association, testing these out. What we find works really well in here is over on this side, and these are double nucleus colonies right here. So there's a partition down the middle, a hive here and a hive over there. They cluster around the middle here, so they function pretty much as a single brood chamber hive, but we find these double nucleus colonies winter over really well in here. So those are the 3 different sizes that we're working with right now. What we find with bees that are wintered indoors is they consume much less food. The average full-size single or double nucleus colony only goes through about 11 pounds of honey through the winter to get through the winter. So when we move them out in the spring, and we're moving them out tomorrow morning, April the 6th, when we move those out, they still have lots of food to get through the spring until the nectar starts coming in. They don't have any brood because since it's dark in here, the queen doesn't lay any eggs. So when they move out, they'll start working on getting some of the spring pollen and start brooding up. But right now they have no brood in them at all. We try to move them out on a cold morning when the bees aren't flying, and that we can do it in the daytime then. If we don't have that kind of condition, we would move them out at night. But tomorrow morning's supposed to be nice and cold, so we'll get these girls out of here. They haven't defecated since December 15th, so we move them out and stand back. That's it. Thanks for watching. See you next time.